Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. Now we are discussing about buffer reader class. Already we discussed scanner class in few videos back. So it is also similar to that, but it has more advantages when compared to scanner class. Okay. So in the scanner class, we need to give input through keyboard. Previously, we are not giving input through keyboard. Later we are, with the help of the command line arguments, we are giving input through keyboard. Later we learned about scanner class. Now we are learning about buffer reader class. Okay. So in this video, we need to learn about buffer reader class. Buffer reader class constructors, buffer reader class methods, buffer reader class examples, and difference between buffer reader and scanner class. Okay. So buffer reader is a Java class that reads text from the input stream. It buffers the characters so that it can get the efficient reading of characters, arrays, etc. It inherits the reader class and makes the code efficient, since we can read the data line by line with the read line method. There are a few pointers we have to keep in mind while working with buffer reader class in Java. We may have to specify the buffer size, even though the default is large enough for any purpose. With each request made of a reader, a corresponding a read request is also made of an underlying character. It is always advised to wrap a buffer reader class around any reader, such as input stream readers. For the programmers that use data input streams for textual input, an appropriate buffer reader replaces the data input stream to localize it. So reads text from a character input stream, buffering character so as to provide for the efficient reading of characters, arrays, and lines. The buffer size may be specified, or the default size may be used. The default is large enough for most purposes. In general, each read request made of a reader causes a corresponding read request to be made of the underlying character or byte stream. It is therefore advisable to wrap a buffer reader around any reader whose read operations may be constantly, such as file readers and input stream readers. Programmers that use data input stream for textual input can be localized by replacing each data input stream with an appropriate buffer reader. Okay. Now, the constructors: buffer reader, reader input stream, reader, reader, buffer reader, 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 init size. This constructor creates a buffering character input stream that works on a default size input buffer. It uses the specified size for the input buffer for buffering the character input stream. Now, the methods are very limited in buffer reader. So when compared to scanner class, we learned 39 methods in scanner class, but here we are learning only 9 methods for solving the purposes. So int read reads a single character. String read line, it reads a line of text. Void reset repositions the stream to the position where the mark method was last called. Int read character cb, int of int length, reads the characters in a portion of an array. Boolean mark supported, it tests the input stream support for rest, reset, and mark method. Boolean ready, it checks whether the input stream is ready for reading. Long skip long n, skips the characters. Void close, it closes the input stream. Void mark, it read int read ahead limit, use it to mark the current position in the stream. So now we are going to know more about buffer reader. This is the example program we are making it into account. So before going to it, I need to tell 3 very, very important points while implementing buffer reader class. The first important point is the buffer reader is available in IO stream, IO packages. So we import IO package into our program by using import java.io.star. That is the first step we need to make it. And the second step is, whenever we are using public static void main, throws io exception. That is the second point we need to second. And add throws io exceptions. So third step is create object for buffer reader. Okay, so here these two lines makes creating an object for buffer reader. You can also write in a single line. Here we are writing in the multiple lines. Input stream reader r is equal to new input stream r reader of system dot in. Buffer reader br is equal to new buffer reader of br r. Okay, instead of r we need to write new input stream reader of system dot in. Okay, that is what exactly. Thirdly, fourth one is we need to use the methods of buffer reader. That is what exactly. So here br.readline to read the text of this. Okay, that is what exactly the buffer reader contains. So here always read.line takes textual data. Now the textual data is converted into an integer or float or double by using wrapper classes. Okay. So in practically I will show how we are doing it. Here we need to learn the basic things. Okay, next is we need to know the difference between buffer reader and scanner class. Buffer reader one side and scanner class another side. Synchronizers and should be used with multiple threads, not synchronizers and not used with multiple threads. Buffer memory is large, buffer memory is smaller, faster than scanner, slower because it does parsing of the input data. There is no ambiguity related to next line method. There is a lot of problems with the next line method. Uses buffer reader to read characters from the character input stream. It is a simple text scanner which parses primitive types and strings. This is what exactly the differences. Okay, this is one of the important question, and already I mentioned how we need to read it. Thank you.